March was a busy month at the Defense Language Institute Foreign Language Center. In addition to our regular schedule of teaching foreign languages 5 days a week, 7 hours per day, the Institute also hosted two distinguished visitors. The commanding general of the U.S. Army Training and Doctrine Command, General Gary Brito, visited the Defense Language Institute Foreign Language Center and the Presidio of Monterey on March 9th, for the first time since he has been in command. Major General Anthony Hale, the commanding general of the Intelligence Center of Excellence in Fort Huachuca, Arizona, accompanied Brito on his trip to Monterey to introduce him to the dynamics of the foreign language mission.
We wanted to show him the importance of this great institution, this world-class facility that trains linguists from across the Department of Defense, and how language is so important for our next fight, and what DLI is doing to train our soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, and Coast Guardsmen for their mission.
Brito had the opportunity to meet DLIFLC and POM leadership and commanders of the four services and Coast Guard, all of which have students attending the Army-led Institute.
We were able to show General Brito two Russian language courses, a first semester course and then a third semester course.
On behalf of the United States,
от имени правительства США,
Brito also participated in a simultaneous interpretation exercise with members of the Defense Threat Reduction Agency team, a high-level Russian course, where he role-played a scenario of U.S.-Russian negotiations.
Very impressed with the instructors, the cadre, the leadership, and more importantly, these young soldiers from the rank of PFC and above, and how they grasp what they do, and do it well, and just have a passion for it.
I'll talk to Private Calhoun here in a minute about his mustache, but anyway, I understand that's a new thing at DLI, you know, mustache march, right?
During his visit, Hale awarded two service members, Private First Class Randall Orif Leal, for being accepted to the U.S. Military Academy at West Point, and Private Caleb Calhoun, for his community service carried out at the former Fort Ord area.
Go make yourself, your family proud. Okay, and come out in 4 years as a commissioned officer in the United States Army, okay? So for that, I want to give you one of my coins. You've probably gotten a challenge coin before?
Yes, sir, I have.
Okay, but you haven't got one like this, because on the back is a Buffalo Soldier against the Huachuca Mountains. And Fort Huachuca is the only installation in the United States of America that housed, trained, and deployed all four recognized units of the Buffalo Soldiers. And the Buffalo Soldiers were the all African American units from 1892 to 1945. So go crush it, okay, buddy?
Thank you very much, sir.
Take care. Good. Ortho Leo just bowed his chest up a little bit. He's getting ready for our day. Thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you.
Absolutely.